Sir, let us see the syllabus. Part A consists of 40 marks. Part B consists of 60 marks. In Part A, subjects are divided as business law, so business law 10, each unit consists of 10 marks in the examination. For business law 10 marks are there, financial accounting 10 marks, corporate accounting 10 marks. In fourth unit is subdivided into two units. One unit is auditing and another unit is FIT, fundamentals of information technology. And fifth unit is business economics. Okay. Then sixth unit is business organization and management. Business statistics is seventh unit. Financial services, banking and insurance, FSBI. The 8th unit has 10 marks. And 9th unit is general English, 10 marks. And 10th one, general knowledge and current affairs, including mainly in the field of commerce and business. Please understand this. In the field of commerce and business, current affairs. And the current affairs, and mainly you can see RBI, Reserve Bank of India, Finance Commission, or Niti Aayog, like this. Who is the current chairman? Who is the current president or secretary? What is their term? Or likewise, questions may be given. Kabatti, vaati gurinchina current affairs nerchukoni undavalsina avasaram untundi. Okay, na? So today's class, I will start with one current affairs item, that is finance commissions. How many finance commissions have been constituted till now? అనేది మనం ఒక్కసారి చూస్తే ఇప్పటి వరకు ఉన్న ఫైనాన్స్ కమిషన్స్ అండి ఇవి. ప్లీజ్ నోట్ డౌన్ అట్లీస్ట్ ఫస్ట్ వన్ అండ్ ప్రెజెంట్ వన్, యూ ప్లీజ్ మేక్ ఎ నోట్. మై సిన్సియర్ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఈజ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ పాయింట్స్ దట్ ఐ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ కైండ్లీ నోట్ డౌన్. సింప్లీ డోంట్ లిసన్, దిస్ ఈజ్ నాట్ ఎ మూవీ టు వ్యూ, దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎ క్లాస్. యూ హ్యావ్ టు నోట్ డౌన్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్స్ while I am explaining. The first finance commission was constituted in 1952 and its duration was from 1952 to 1957. The chairperson's name was K.C. Niyogi. Tarvata present first one and present one, please make a note. First one was K.C. Niyogi and present one N.K. Singh. The period is from 2020 to 25. So like this, you have to have a look at the current affairs with a special focus on commerce, with a special focus on banking, with a special focus on finance, with a special focus on important business persons or industries, how they are performing, who is their chairman. So all these things you have to note. So whatever I explained, please kindly make a note. Now you see, recently these are the finance commissions which have been operative in India till date. మన భారతదేశంలో ఈ ఫైనాన్స్ కమిషన్స్ ఏర్పాటు చేయటం జరిగింది. ప్రజెంట్ ఫైనాన్స్ కమిషన్ ఈ 15th ఫైనాన్స్ కమిషన్. ప్లీజ్ మేక్ ఎ నోట్. ఫస్ట్ వన్ వాజ్ కాన్స్టిట్యూటెడ్ ఇన్ ద ఇయర్ 1952, 5 years పీరియడ్ 1952 to 57. ద చైర్పర్సన్ వాజ్ కేసీ నియోగి. నౌ ప్రజెంట్ చైర్పర్సన్ ఈజ్ శ్రీ ఎన్కే సింగ్. సో విత్ దిస్ కరెంట్ అఫైర్స్ ఐ విల్ స్టార్ట్ అవర్ ఒరిజినల్ సబ్జెక్ట్. ఓకే, now coming to first unit. So these are the topics in business laws that have to be discussed. I will give a bird's eye view of all the topics. Okay, important points, key points I will tell. Kindly make a note. law of contracts, including essential elements of a valid contract, contingency contract, performance, discharge, breach and remedies for breach of contract, quasi contracts, special contracts, including bailment contracts, agency contracts, sale of goods act, conditions and warranties. See, up to here actually business laws. The contract act, especially with reference to contract act. These are separate laws, Consumer Protection Act and Companies Act. And including the concepts of doctrine of ultra-vires and doctrine of indoor management. So these are the topics, subtopics in the first unit. So we will discuss one by one. Okay. So coming to Indian Contract Act. When was Indian Contract Act established? In 1872, Indian Contract Act was established. Kindly make a note. What is a contract? See, contract, two things are necessary in a contract. Okay? Those two things are, one, agreement should be there between two parties. And enforceability of law should be there. These two are the essential conditions of a contract. Agreement should be there between two parties. Please kindly make a note. Okay, agreement. What is agreement? Agreement is, in simple terms, it is common understanding. And please remember, according to section 2, subsection B, contract was defined in Indian Contract Act. Definition was defined under 2, subsection B, 2 of B. Contract was defined. Contract implies agreement plus enforceability of law. See, normally we will have several agreements in the family, in society, but some of the agreements do not have enforceability. Means, suppose if I promise my friend to take him to movie in tomorrow's first show in so and so theater, but it is agreement, but it is not enforceable by law because it is a social agreement which cannot be enforced. So agreement should be there, enforceability by law should be there. Okay. In agreement, generally we will have promises. Promise means every promise or every set of promises form into consideration for each other. I will do this act, you should do that act. That is what you mean by saying promise. I will agree to do certain thing or I will agree to do not to do certain thing. That is my promise. And I expect the same equivalent return from the other party. That constitutes agreement. Agreement is defined under section 2E of Indian Contract Act. So a proposal when accepted becomes a promise. So this is defined under section 2B of Indian Contract Act. A proposal when accepted becomes a promise. So what is a promise? What is agreement? What is Indian Contract Act? When it was established? These things are very, very important. What are the two main things? See, you have to also remember that every contract is an agreement, but every agreement is not a contract. I repeat, every contract is an agreement, but every agreement is not a contract. Because I told, social contracts will be there, family contracts will be there, they cannot be enforced by law. Only those agreements which can be enforced by law, enforceable by law, are termed as contracts. So that we have to keep in mind. Okay. And another important topic that you have to remember is under section 10, this is important, section 10. According to section 10, essentialities of a valid contract have been given. Again, 10 essentialities are there, 10 essentials are there of a valid contract. There should be offer, there should be acceptance. intention to create legal relationship, lawful consideration, capacity of parties should be there. See, I hope you know that minors cannot enter into agreements. Who is the minor? That is the question. See, in India, in different countries, minor is defined under different ways. In India, a person who is below 18 years is defined as a minor. Who is below 18 years is defined as a minor in India. Please make a note. Minors cannot enter into agreements. They are void agreements, void ab initio. From the beginning itself, contracts with minors are void agreements. Okay, so as per section 10, capacity of parties, three kinds of parties cannot enter into contract. One is minor, and the second person is a person of unsound mind. Minors, persons of unsound mind, and persons declared explicitly by court of law that they are ineligible to enter into contract. Who are they? In the subsequent classes we will learn, but for the time being, three kinds of parties are termed as incompetent to enter into contract. So where it was given 18, the person who is below 18 years will be termed as minor. Where it was given? It was given in Majority Age Act, not Minority Age Act. Please remember, Majority Age Act was constituted in India in the year 1875. Please make a note. Majority Age Act was enacted in India in 1875. According to it, under Section 3, the person who is below 18 years will be termed as minor. Similarly, we have to remember another thing also. Another act is also there, enacted in India with reference to minority. A person who is below 21 years will be considered in India as a minor, provided that particular person has a guardian. Guardian means just in hostels, we will have wards to take care of children, to take care of people. Similarly, for those whose parents are not alive, or those children who have not been taken care of well by the parents, in such conditions, court under Guardian and Wards Act. Please kindly make a note. Guardian and Wards Act. This was enacted in India in 1890. According to this act, if a guardian takes care of an individual, in that case, the person will be termed as minor up to 21 years of age. Please kindly make a note. Normally, in normal conditions, under Majority Age Act 1875, Section 3, a person will be termed as minor if he is below 18 years of age. But for an individual, if a ward is there under 1890s Guardian and Wards Act, then that person will attain the age of majority at the age of 21. So these two things you have to remember. Under which act, up to 18 years will be termed as a minor. Under which act, a person will be termed as a minor under 21. That you have to remember, these two acts and essentials of valid contract. We will move forward. Free and genuine consent should be there, and a lawful object should be there. Agreement should not be declared as void. So void means, I clearly mentioned, void is not enforced by law right from the beginning. Okay, void ab initio, right from the beginning, they cannot be enforced. Or sometimes
what happens? Suppose if a party dies in between, before execution of the contract, after the two parties, one party dies, in that case the agreement will be void agreement, because it cannot be continued. Certainty and possibility of performance should be there. Legal formalities should be there. These are the 10 essentials of a contract. These are defined under Section 10 of Indian Contract Act. Then types of contracts. The valid contract, void contract, voidable contract, void agreements. See, earlier I mentioned contract agreement with minor will be void agreement. It cannot be enforced. You cannot term it as a contract. It is a void agreement. Unenforceable contracts. Illegal agreements. Based on their validity, contracts are divided like this. Express contract, implied contract, quasi contract, e-commerce contract. Based on their formation, division was there like that. So based on performance, executed, executory, unilateral, bilateral. This you have to understand. Valid contract is a contract which satisfies all the 10 conditions that were mentioned under Section 10. Void contract, it cannot be enforced by law. Even if one is missing out of the 10 essential conditions, that is a void contract. Please remember, a void contract is a contract in which at least one characteristic feature that is mentioned under Section 10 of the essentials of a valid contract is missing. That is termed as a void contract. So voidable. Voidable contract is a contract in which if one party does not agree, if one party does not satisfy, if it has a choice to get out of the contract, that is a voidable contract. In simple terms, in general terms, I am explaining. Voidable. See, suppose I will tell you with an example. Suppose X and Y are friends. X is cheated by Y. And a contract was reached between the two, X and Y. So after some days, X came to know that Y cheated him. So now it is up to X. If he decides to withdraw from the contract, it is voidable. So if one of the parties is not satisfied, if it has a choice to get out of the contract, that is voidable. So void agreement. So I told, you know, some agreements, social agreements, family agreements, agreements which cannot be enforced because of various reasons. They are void agreements. Agreement with the minor, agreement with lunatics, unenforceable. Some contracts are unenforceable because of proper stamps are not there, proper signatures are not there, proper evidence is not there. In such a case, they cannot be enforced. That is an unenforceable contract. Illegal agreements. See, illegal agreements are those agreements which work against the government, which works against the general good of the people. That is illegal agreement. So agreement for smuggling, just for example. So based on their validity, this division is there. So express contract. Express means clearly terms are written. Clearly terms are orally told. That is express contract. What a party does, what other party does is clearly mentioned in that contract. Implied contract means clear mention will not be there, but based on the behavior of a party to a contract, we can assume that there is a contract. Suppose let us take for example, if we go to a hotel and we drink tea, we take tea. So that is, there is a contract between us, between the hotel owner and us. There is no written agreement. There is no written contract. There is no express contract. But by the behavior of us, the hotel owner thinks that I am ready to pay the amount which is fixed for tea. So that is implied contract.
quasi contract, please try to understand quasi contract. Quasi contracts are not generally contracts, but they are enforceable by law, by government. Quasi contracts, there is no express agreement between parties, but it is enforceable by law. It is enforceable by law. How? How means, suppose I have lost my bag in a bus. The person who gets that bag is bound to return it to me, provided my address is there in the bag. So here, I have a right to take it from him. He has the responsibility to return it to me. So that is a quasi contract. There is no clear expression. It is implied. The court will be on behalf, will support me. So that those kinds of contracts are known as quasi contracts. Now e-commerce contracts, electronic commerce contracts, that you all know. Nowadays, some contracts are being entered into with the help of electronic means, with the help of WhatsApp, with the help of Facebook, or with the help of any other electronic means. So based on formation, electronic commerce contracts are those contracts which are entered into with the help of electronic means. So based on performance, executed. Executed means already parties in a contract have completed their task. They fulfilled their promises. That is executed contract. Executory means one party or the other party may not have completed the contract. In that case, that is executory. A unilateral means only one party has fulfilled the promise, other party has to fulfill it. Bilateral means two parties to a contract have to fulfill their promises. Let us take, for example, I go to a railway station. I take the help of a porter to get my baggage into train. See, if I pay money first, the porter has to load my baggage into train. So I paid money first. So in that case, it is unilateral contract. And my job is finished. His job is not finished. Bilateral. I did not pay money. He did not put my baggage in the train. So here two parties have to fulfill promises. Unilateral. Only one party has to fulfill promise, complete promise. So these are the various types of contracts.